Hi all. In our last session, we have already mentioned how to prepare a comparative statement, whether it is comparative balance sheet or comparative income statement. Now we are specifically going through a problem on preparation of comparative balance sheet. This is the format of a balance sheet. If we are given with such a balance sheet, here we have two amount columns, 2011 and 2012. Okay, then based on this balance sheet, we have to prepare. It is here, it is in this balance sheet. Here it is assets, current assets. All the current assets are shown. Then total current assets. Then second heading, fixed assets. All the fixed assets are shown. Then total fixed assets. So the total A is current assets, total B is fixed assets, and total assets. These are the two items to be covered in the asset side. Then in liability side, we have current liabilities, then account receivable and other current liabilities are shown. Total current liabilities, total A. Then fixed liabilities, debenture, term loan, etc. are this. Total long term liabilities, total B. Then third heading, equity, share capital, reserves and surplus, etc. These are covered as shareholders fund. Then total of A, B and C will be total liabilities. This is how we are preparing a balance sheet in the new format. Now, if we are given with such a balance sheet, how we will prepare a comparative balance sheet? That is how what we are discussing now. This is how the comparative balance sheet of a company is prepared. Here, with the balance sheet, we have added two more columns. Okay, one is this column, absolute change, absolute increase or decrease. Second, percentage change. These are the two columns added here. Okay, then here, just we have a look at this balance sheet. Here, all the items are same, all the items in the balance sheet are same, but we have added two more columns and we are showing these items. For example, cash at bank. Cash at bank, first year 118, second year 10. So it has decreased. So in absolute change column, we will show minus 108. We can show this just like this, or simply put 108 in bracket. Okay, if it is the negative figure, generally we will put it in the bracket. Okay, it is 108. And next is percentage change. Percentage change is 91.52. Height is calculated 108 divided by 118. Then we will get 91.52. Okay, likewise, all the items in the balance sheet, account receivable, inventory, all these are shown here. 209, 118, minus 19, then 9.09% decrease. Okay, if it is negative figure, we can show minus. If it is positive figure, we can show positive. Okay, then total current assets, then fixed assets, liabilities, all these are shown as in the format given in the question. Simply, the main thing is that you have to learn the format of a balance sheet. In the new format, on the asset side, there are only two headings, current assets, total current assets, fixed assets, total assets. So only two heading, current assets and fixed assets. On liability side, there are only three headings. One is current liabilities, second one is fixed liabilities, third one is shareholders fund. Okay, then for all these items, we will provide two more additional columns, absolute change column. Here we will show increase or decrease in amount, then percentage change column. Here we will show the percentage increase or decrease. This is how we will prepare a comparative balance sheet. Comparative income statement is also prepared just like this. Okay, I think you have got the idea as to how to prepare a comparative balance sheet. Okay, then I am giving you a new balance sheet. Okay, you are required to prepare a comparative balance sheet. Okay, Here, let us discuss these items. On the asset side, there are current assets, fixed assets, investments. On the liability side, share capital, reserves and surplus, long-term loan, current liabilities. Okay, then in the new, it is better you to prepare the balance sheet in the new format. If you are solving the problem in the same format, there is no problems, but it is better to solve the problem in this format we have already discussed. In the new format, firstly we will start with the assets, then we will start with the current assets, then total current assets, fixed assets. In fixed assets, we can also show investments and total fixed assets, total assets. On liability side, here current liabilities, total current liabilities, long term loan come under fixed liabilities. So current liabilities, total current liabilities, fixed liabilities or non current liabilities, we will show long term loan. Then shareholders fund, here we will show capital and reserves and surplus. When we total both three items, we will get the total of liability side. Okay, then based on this problem, you are required to prepare a comparative balance sheet. When you prepare the comparative balance sheet, it is to be noted that you have to give two more columns, absolute increase or decrease. Next column, percentage increase or decrease. For example, if you are showing current assets, it will be shown as 210,000 in 2010, 240,000 in 2011. In the next column, increase or decrease column, we can show 30,000 because the absolute increase or decrease is 30,000. In the next column, you have to show percentage increase or decrease. The percentage increase is 30,000 divided by 210,000 into 100. Then you will get the percentage. You have to show the percentage in the percentage column. Okay, this is how you have to prepare a comparative balance sheet. So take this problem, as your assignment question, solve the problem and find the solution. You, all of you, are required to give the answer. Your problem should be solved in a notebook, and you take a photo of that solved problem and post the solution, post the photo either into my WhatsApp number, or you can add it in the assignment part of the Google Classroom. Okay, if you have any queries, you can contact me. Okay, thank you.